Okay, so we are going to use the regular expressions to try and extract the text which is contained between the p tags inside here. Now you saw a couple of videos earlier where we were fumbling trying to find different means. Beautiful soup is a good way of doing it, but we're just going to use it. We're just going to do it using NLTK and the regular expression library contained within it. And Mike, do you want to take us through that? So we've got the individual stages prepared over, shut that down.
Yeah.
Individual stages archived there. So let's run it for real.
Okay, so starting from scratch now, to make it a bit cleaner, obviously the first thing we need to do is import.
NLTK, because that's what the whole module's about, right?
And we want to use a regular
expression. Expressions, so we know what they do, their filters.
Oh,
space, look, space.
Got a space there.
Yeah.
Oh dear, oh dear. Okay,
still
taking,
got it.
Taking that space out. I think that space is, yeah, that's okay.
Right.
And we want to use URL lib, so we're going to import URL lib.
And remember what that does, that's just going to pull in a page for us in its entirety.
We're going to open our Monty Python page, and we're going to install it into store it into an object called response.
Which will just be a memory location where all that data begins.
We're going to get the HTML output from that response.
So we're going to read it from that memory location. So HTML is now the raw text, including all the tags.
We're now going to turn it from object form into string form.
That's because it was byte and we want it into string.
We're now going to search for the tags.
So we're searching for P and backslash P.
Yeah, and this will show this wildcard here is everything in between
these
two tags.
Everything in between, yep.
And this will return the first found search entry.
So we want to have a look at M, don't we?
Have a look at M, and we can see.
Yep, so there it is. It starts at 7's character, that is 7679, and finishes at character 9.
No, this is the length. This is the length.
Ah, okay.
So it starts here, and it's at this length.
Okay.
Yeah. So now what we can do is we can create a new variable based on those indexes. So we want to start at 7.
Now, if you were looking to automate this, you would have to parse that string above and get those two numbers out.
Yeah, I mean, are
but we know how to do that.
Yeah, the regular expression search.
Yeah, we'll leave the students to do that. We're not going to do that for them.
Just want to make it as simple as possible.
Yeah.
So I'm going to then have a look.
So paragraph should contain the text.
Let's see if we've actually got it. There we go.
Yeah.
So the only last piece of formatting to do on this
is
to take the P's out. And I think we can probably leave the students to figure out how to do that.
Something to do for their assignment.
might be able to do it in regular expression. Might be able to modify this regular expression to not include the P's in the response.
Yeah.
That's option one, number two. Post formatting, you might be able to change these indexes to knock them out like that. You might be able to use a third, a new regular expression to take it out.
Yeah.
There's many ways to.
Or you could use a completely separate library, which is quite good at doing what we just did automatically.
Yeah.
The choice is yours, but. Just a sort of longhand way of doing it, but it's more understandable, I think.
So what's interesting about these videos, these last few videos, is we did not initially know how to achieve this goal. And so we've gone in off the cuff to try and find a way to provide a solution. So, you know, it's a bit all over the place. We've done a lot of Google searching, but that's real life in programming, isn't it?
It's exactly what you do, because NLTK is quite well defined, but there's lots of libraries out there. For example, voice synthesis, voice recognition, all these kind of things, where you may not use them every day and they may not be particularly well documented, but nevertheless there'll be a page telling you what that particular class, what that particular library is capable of doing, and then afterwards you can do your own stuff with it. So, yeah, the Google search is a classic way of solving most things. Okay.